Have you ever wanted to use GitHub Actions to deploy infrastructure on Google Cloud using Terraform? If so, then this is the video for you. What's up, everybody? It's Ned Bellavance, Ned1313 on Twitter, and welcome to Terraform Tuesday. Today's topic is all about setting up self-hosted runners on GCP to integrate with GitHub Actions and get stuff deployed on GCP using an integrated service account. Now, if that sounds kind of confusing, I will definitely dig into that in a moment. Before I do that, two quick things I want to go over. Number one, did you know that I have a podcast called Day 2 Cloud that I host with Ethan Banks? It is full of amazing episodes. And let me tell you, we've had some really good episodes in the last 2 months. So I highly encourage you to check out day2cloud.io. The link is down in the description and see what you think of the podcast. The other thing I want to mention is sponsorships are available for Terraform Tuesdays. If you're a vendor with a way cool product that integrates with Terraform or does something with Terraform, reach out to me. Let's talk. Let's see if you're a good fit for Terraform Tuesdays, and maybe you could sponsor an episode. Now, with that out of the way, let's talk about self-hosted runners on GCP for GitHub Actions. Okay, so what's the big idea here? What's the big idea here? What am I trying to accomplish? What's the whole point of using self-hosted runners in GCP with GitHub Actions? All right, let's back up a little bit. Okay, so if you've ever used GitHub Actions, you know that that is a configuration file that's hosted with your repository. And when something happens, an event happens in your repository, GitHub will spin up a hosted runner, which is a container hosted by GitHub that will run through the actions that are defined for that event. That's essentially what GitHub Actions is doing. Now, one of the things you can do is deploy resources or manage existing resources with Terraform through GitHub Actions. Unfortunately, if you want to connect to a cloud or anything else, you're going to need credentials. And typically the way you would do that is storing your credentials information as secrets, either in the repository or in your organization. Now that might be suboptimal. So what other options do you have? Well, here's an interesting option. You can go with what's called self-hosted runners. These are a virtual machine or a container running somewhere that is running the GitHub Actions runner software and is registered either with your repository or with the organization as a whole. Now, when you write your GitHub Actions file, you can target that self-hosted runner instead of using the GitHub hosted runner. Okay, now what does that have to do with Google Cloud? Well, if you've watched my Getting Started video on Google Cloud, you'll know there's a number of different ways to authenticate to Google Cloud. You can do it using the integrated CLI authentication. You can use a service account where you generate some service account token information, or you can use integrated authentication if you're running from a Google Compute instance. Now we know where we're going with this. If I put my self-hosted runners in Google Cloud and associate those compute instances with a service account, now I can use the integrated authentication from that service account to provision infrastructure in Google Cloud and not have to store any secret information with my GitHub repository or organization. So that's the big idea. That's what we want to accomplish here. Let's talk about what components are going to make this up, and we're going to deploy the whole thing using Terraform. All right, now that we have our arms around the big concept, the question is, what resources do I need to create in Google Cloud to make this whole self-hosted runner thing hum? Well, the first thing I need to do is create a GCP project, because that's where all the other resources will live. Fortunately, if you watched the Getting Started GCP video, you know in that video, we created a Terraform configuration that basically creates a project in GCP and then enables the necessary APIs for that project and then returns that project ID. That's kind of perfect. So we're going to use that as a module for the self-hosted runner project. All right, cool. So we're going to need that. Then we're going to need the self-hosted runner itself. So we're going to create a managed instance group. And fortunately, someone at Google already wrote a module, and it's on the Terraform registry for creating self-hosted runners for GitHub Actions. Unfortunately, it's very much in beta and already broken. So I couldn't use that, but I could use most of it. So I copied it down locally and made some alterations. And now we're going to use that as part of the configuration as well. What other things do I need? Well, if I'm going to be generating configurations in Terraform with GitHub Actions, I'm going to want to store my state somewhere. So why not create a Google Cloud storage bucket in the same project as my self-hosted runners, and that is where I'll store all of my remote state files for each configuration that gets managed by my GitHub Actions. Okay, so we're going to create that bucket. And then finally, I need a service account to associate with those instances, and that service account needs permissions to create new projects when we want to generate new infrastructure using GitHub Actions. So it's going to need to be able to create some new projects, associate them with a billing account, and also read some roles. So we're going to set up that service account, associate it with the managed instances, and then give it the permissions it needs. So that's the high level of everything we need to deploy. Why don't we go over to VS Code, and I'll walk through the Terraform configuration with you. All right, here we are in Visual Studio Code. If you're looking for these configuration files, you can always find them on my GitHub account. It's Ned1313, and the repository is called Terraform Tuesdays. It's really easy to find. I put it up on the screen. There you go. The directory we're going to be working in this time is 2021-09-14 GCP runner. And the point of this configuration is to set up our remote runners on Google Cloud to get them ready to accept some GitHub Actions from other repositories. Now, I'm not going to walk through the entire configuration because that would take forever, and you can do that yourself, but I do want to hit a few highlights. We'll start with the project creation. Well, actually, let's start with the main.tf file. So let's go over to that, and I'm going to hide the terminal because we don't really need that. And we just take a look at the structure here. The first thing I'm going to do is invoke a module called project, which I have stored in the project creation folder. What's this module do? Where, if you remember from the getting started, the whole point of this is to create a project in GCP to host resources. Well, I need to host my self-hosted runner somewhere, so I'm going to create a project for those managed instance group and also the service account and the bucket to all live. So that's what the project creation module does, and it returns back the project ID. Then we're going to create that service account for the managed instance group. No big deal there. And then we're going to apply the permissions that service account will need if it's going to act as a self-hosted runner creating resources on GCP. So we're setting this at the organization level, organization in Google Cloud, I should clarify. And we're giving it the roles viewer, resource manager, project creator, and billing user. That way it will be able to create a new project and associate billing with that project. And then as part of a separate Terraform configuration, we can grant this service account permissions on a project to create resources inside it. But that'll be part of the GitHub Actions that the remote runner is doing. So we won't worry about that right now. Okay, scrolling down a little bit more, I make use of the module that I've customized a little bit from what was posted on the Terraform registry. The one that was on there was specific to a repository. So remember, I think I mentioned this earlier, the self-hosted runners can be associated with a repository or the entire organization. Now, in my case, I want to associate this runner with more than one repository. So I'm going to do it at the organization level. The module only allowed for repository level, so I had to rewrite some portions of the module to allow for organization level. That's what I did here. So we feed it in the project ID to tell it where to create these runners, and we also have to give it some information about our GitHub organization, our GitHub organization URL, and most importantly, a token, a personal access token that I created that has permissions to create a runner registration token through the GitHub API. Now that token has admin org level permissions. So that token's kind of important. You want to be careful with that token, just so you know. And then the service account tells it what service account to associate with these instances. Then we create the storage account and bucket for the remote state that we'll be storing when we start running some stuff through these remote runners. And then we have to give the service account access to manipulate that bucket. So we give it storage object admin permissions on that bucket, which means it can do whatever it wants with objects in this bucket. It can't delete the bucket, but it can manipulate anything inside of the bucket. So that's, at a very high level, everything that's in the Terraform configuration. Now, I do want to dig into the runner creation module a little bit, so let's do that now. All right, we've gone through the main body of the configuration. If we expand out runner creation, I just want to point out a couple things here, mostly having to do with the startup script. So this startup script, again, I got this from the Terraform registry, and somebody at Google wrote this, which is why all the boilerplate stuff is in there. What we're doing that's a little bit different, and if we go down here to where it actually generates an input token to register itself, runners register themselves with your organization or your repository. So to get the token to do that, we have to reference the GitHub API. And in this case, we're doing it at the organization level. And then the action is runner's registration token. So that gives us a token to register our runner. And then we run the configuration script for the runner software and pass it our organization URL, because that's where we want it to be registered. And we pass it the token we just generated to register it. So that happens on startup. It registers itself. And then when it shuts down, it runs a different action. It runs the remove token action, which removes the registration of that runner from your organization. So as VM instances come up and go down, they will register and then remove themselves from your organization dynamically. So that is pretty cool. I just wanted to point out that was the major change I made. Eventually, I'm hoping to fork this and update it so A, it's not broken, and B, it allows you to select whether you want to launch it for a repository or a whole organization. So that's pretty much everything in the code. I've already run it, so let's jump over to GitHub and also Google Cloud, and I'll tell you what you need to set up in GitHub before you run this. In order to run this configuration, you need a GitHub organization. The good news is, you can create a GitHub organization for free, and the runners don't really cost you anything except the cost of running them in GCP. So that's not going to cost you anything on the GitHub side. Now, what do you need to actually do this? Well, you need your organization. In my case, it's Ned in the Cloud, but you don't want the display name. You want the actual name of your organization. So if I go to my profile and look at my organizations, you'll see that one of them is Ned-in-the-cloud. That's what you use for the organization name. Now, what else do I need? I need that personal access token. How do you go about that? You'll go into the settings for your profile, and then in there, you'll go down to developer settings and personal access tokens, and then you'll click on generate a new token, and then you can give it a name. I recommend giving it a name. You can set an expiration. By default, it's 30 days. And then the permissions it needs is admin org. That will give it permissions to create that runner token and create a new token to revoke it. So that's what you need to set up in GitHub. That's the information you'll need for the Terraform configuration to run. Once it's done running, if we go over to GCP, this is the project that was created. And in the project, I've got two VM instances here. So these are my two runners that it spun up. So I've got redundancy here if one fails. If I go over into the storage portion of the console and look at cloud storage, we can see, let it load. Isn't it nice when consoles are slow? There we go. There is one bucket in here called Terraform state. That's where we're going to be storing our remote state. And if we go back to here, and we can cancel out of this because I don't want to do that. Let's go back into my organization, go into settings for Ned in the Cloud, and we'll scroll down here into actions. And in actions, we'll look at runners, and we can see there's two runners available, and they're both idle right now. They're not running anything. Now we could create additional runner groups, and there's a lot more to this, but I just wanted to point out that the runners did successfully register. If we look at the host name for 156G6, that lined up to one of the runners that we saw before in the cloud console for Google Cloud. So this is all set up and ready to go. The next phase is to create a repository that uses GitHub Actions in my organization and take advantage of these runners. All right, in this video, we saw how you can create self-hosted runners in GCP using Terraform. So we're using Terraform for the whole thing, and associate a service account with those self-hosted runners, which then we can use later when we set up our GitHub Actions on a repository so that we don't have to provide authentication information for our GCP resources that we want to create. So that was pretty cool. We got through the whole thing. The next video that I do in this series will show you how to create a new repository, set up GitHub Actions in that repository to create configurations in GCP using Terraform, and then we'll watch the self-hosted runners go through the process of actually provisioning that infrastructure. It's going to be pretty cool. I'm pretty excited about that. All right, that's going to do it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you've subscribed, that's awesome. If you haven't, please subscribe. I appreciate it, and I won't be too bothersome. I swear that I won't. Next thing I want to mention is I'm shutting down my Patreon. Yes, I know. I've been pimping the Patreon for a while, but it hasn't really gained a whole lot of traction, and I'm doing this weekly newsletter for all my patrons, and I'd rather just have everybody get access to that weekly newsletter. So look for more information about that weekly newsletter coming soon. To my patrons, thank you so much for supporting me. I really do appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. Now take that money and go spend it on something awesome, a charity or something like that. You know, go do something else with it. I do appreciate your support. And now you get that newsletter for free. So that's a win-win, right? And then the last thing I want to mention is, because I'm not doing the Patreon, if you would like to support this show in some way, if you're a vendor and you want to sponsor the Terraform Tuesdays, I'd very much appreciate it. So reach out to me on Twitter. Let's have a conversation. If you've got a product you think fits into Terraform Tuesday, I'd love to evaluate it and let you know what I think. So let's talk. Ned1313 on Twitter. That's going to do it for me for today. As always, thank you for listening. Until next time, stay healthy, stay safe out there. Bye for now. So I did the whole video with my Invisalign in because I've gotten pretty used to talking with Invisalign. Did anybody notice? I feel like it was pretty transparent, as it were. Anyway, talk to you later. Bye.